an ISIS nuclear threat. The UN warning that jihadis are plotting to target power plants across Europe. This after learning that a nuclear power plant was targeted 2 years ago. However, that attack was disrupted by a militant cyber attack. I want to bring in retired four-star general and Fox News military analyst, General Jack Keane. General, good to see you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good to be here, Maria.
How concerned are you about this warning?
Well, we've always been concerned about nuclear terrorism and the idea that somebody could be radicalized who's working inside a plant as an insider doing something, or actually possibly blowing up a plant. Now, for ISIS to have the capability to blow up a nuclear power plant, that's probably slim to none. Even an insider threat, it's very rare for someone by themselves to be able to cause a meltdown, because there's so much of a team effort inside a nuclear power plant. People would be observed. However, cyber terrorism dealing with a nuclear power plant, that is an issue, because their cyber capability is growing. And I think that's really what's got some people's concern.
Right. And so they're admitting that a nuclear power plant was already disrupted by a cyber attack.
Yes, that's true. And that occurred in Belgium, and there's been other attempts.
That was 2 years
ago. Correct. Right. We've always been concerned about the cyber capability of terrorists. Think of this. In the United States, our critical infrastructure, financial banking, utility infrastructure, and our transportation system, they are vulnerable to a sophisticated cyber attack that our adversary countries have, Russia, China, to name two. The concern that we've always had, what happens if the terrorists get their hands on that capability or buy it from the Russians, because half of the Russian cyber attack capability is criminal? That is a concern. So as terrorists get more sophisticated, they're going to move more and more to cyber capability.
Of course, they're going to try to do anything they can.
Yeah.
And the International Atomic Energy Agency head revealed that a terrorist had once tried to smuggle highly enriched uranium out of a power plant to build a dirty bomb. Let me move on to this other story. We talked about this the other day. Iranian-backed Houthi rebels firing two missiles at a U.S. Navy destroyer. What do you make of this? Should we be firing back over this? What is the response? Why didn't we attack in response?
Well, this is Iran. Iran is backing the Houthi rebels, trying to take over the country of Yemen. They obviously toppled the government. They forced us to withdraw our special operations base from Yemen. They forced us to withdraw our embassy, which we closed last year as well. What they want is a port. What the Iranians want is a port right there in southern Yemen, so they can actually begin to control access and egress from the Suez Canal, much as they have some influence in the Gulf at the Straits of Hormuz. So this is a strategic issue for the Iranians. What we should be doing, obviously, is what you already suggested. If we know who fired these missiles, let's do something about it. Our problem in the Middle East dealing with Iran is we have had hands-off for years. Democrats and Republicans, the Iranians use their proxies to gain strategic advantage and leverage in the Middle East, and we rarely ever respond, going all the way back to the 80s with President Ronald Reagan, all the way to the present. Yes, if we've got accurate intelligence, we should do something about it.
Why do we rarely respond, and at the same time, sort of, on the one hand, we know that they're an enemy, and on the other hand, we're doing this nuclear deal with them?
Yeah. And
I don't even understand.
You're right. When we sat down to do the nuclear deal, one of the first things we wanted to talk about was Iranians' adventurism in the Middle East. They're sponsoring of terrorism, trying to take over the Middle East, literally.
Right.
They say that's their objective. We wanted to discuss that. The Iranians said no, and they wouldn't come to the table if that was going to be a discussion item. What did we do? We walked away from it.
And we went forward and
made a lousy deal on top of it.
It's just questionable, General. It's so questionable. Let me ask you about ISIS. Apparently, the last 9 months, we are looking at reports that ISIS has reportedly lost 16% of its territory. So the U.S. is winning. U.S.-led coalition airstrikes and ground fighting are actually winning there. It comes ahead of a planned assault on Mosul, the terrorist's biggest stronghold in Iraq. What is the next step in taking down ISIS? And do you believe that to be true, that they are losing ground?
Oh, yeah, they're definitely losing ground. And the strategy that we had, as slow as it's been and critical as myself and others have been of it, we are finally taking back the lost territory that took place in Iraq beginning in January 2014.
What changed? Why are we taking it?
Well, we were able to build up enough forces, enough combat power to overwhelm ISIS. That took some time because the Iraqi army was decimated, as we all saw on television, back in 2014. Now they've got that combat power, not just that, but also the Shia militia, some of it backed by the Iranians, are a considerable force as well. And we have seen from the beginning the Peshmerga, the Kurds, they've been good fighters. Put the three of them together, they'll dominate Mosul in the next number of weeks. You'll see whether ISIS fights or not remains to be seen. What they've been doing ever since Kobani, where they lost so many fighters in Syria, they normally put up a little bit of a fight and then pull their fighters out of there. But yes, Iraq will be retaken. There's huge political issues in Iraq and huge disagreements in Iraq. There's a lot of work to be done there politically in terms of unity, even after ISIS goes. But ISIS is still sitting on a stronghold in Syria from which it conducts its worldwide and global operations. That has got to be destroyed. We do not have any immediate plans to destroy it.
Because you're also looking at a situation that's changed, because if you look to destroy and take down Syria, you're getting in Russia's hair.
Yes.
Isn't that true?
That's part of the problem, but we can deal with ISIS without interfering with Russia. And we certainly,
yes.
I never thought we should be working with the Russians, cooperating over ISIS, because the Russians are committing genocide and war crimes in Syria and back in the Assad regime. And
right,
all
exactly.
of that is well documented, and we should not be working with those.
And they inserted themselves.
Yeah,
the Russians completely inserted themselves. General, always a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much. General Jack Keane there.